Welcome to the Brightspace demo instruction video. In this video, we will show you how you as a teacher can set up your exam and what your students will see when they take the exam in the Aletta Jacob Hall. First, we're going to start by logging into Brightspace. You will see the following home screen. Here you can click on the Brightspace exam course for the exam that you want to set up. In our case, we go to Exam Test Detail in our list of courses. From here, you go to your content page by clicking Content in the blue navigation bar at the top. In the content page of your exam, you will find two units, one called Exam and one called Exam Essentials. This last unit contains items that can help you with the setup of your exam, such as the link to assessment manuals and the instructions for the lecturer. The first unit contains two instruction items that will be visible to the student during the exam, called Brightspace Exam Instructions and Exam Instructions. We have also added a quiz with examples of all the question types that we will show you later in this video. To start adding questions to your exam, click on the unit named Exam, then click Create New and click Quiz. Give the quiz a title and then add a question by clicking Create New and then choose New Question. Here you can choose which type of question you would like. For this demo, we will show you how to create a multiple choice question and an open question. We will start with the multiple choice question. Fill in the question text and the possible answer options. Mark which answer is correct, and once you have finished, click Save. As you can see, the question has now been created. We will now show you how to make one more question. This time it will be a written response question, which is an open question where students write down their answer. Fill in the question text, and at the right-hand side of the screen you can see a preview of what your question will look like. Then fill in the amount of points and click Save. Now at the top, make sure that your quiz is added to the gradebook, so that your students' grades will be recorded in the gradebook. For this quiz, you can see that students can score a total of 4 points on all the questions. Then lastly, at the right-hand side of the screen, you can adjust further settings to your quiz. These settings, such as availability conditions and time restrictions, will be double-checked for you by team assessment support. Right now, we will show you how to change one of the settings that prohibits students from seeing their preliminary score at the end of the quiz. Click Evaluation and Feedback. If you do not want your students to see their preliminary score, you can uncheck the Attempt Grade box here. For now, we're going to leave everything else as it is. Now you can preview your quiz to see if everything looks as you expected. To do that, click Preview. This will open a preview of the quiz in a new tab. Click Start Quiz at the bottom, and here you see both questions that we just created. As you see, the moment you fill out an answer, a checkmark appears next to the question to show that the question was just auto-saved. Click Submit the Quiz, and now you've submitted the quiz, all in a preview test setting, of course. You can go ahead and close the preview tab. If you are happy with your quiz and you have finished adding all your questions, then click Save and Close at the bottom. You will now be brought back to your content folder. You can see that our quiz has been added to the exam unit here. Now we're going to show you what it looks like when a student logs into the exam hall computers in the Aletta Jacob Hall to take their exam. Here you see the opening screen that a student will see once they log into the exam. At the top, we see the standard Brightspace instruction explaining how they can save and submit their answers. Underneath, we see exam instructions that you as the teacher can add and edit yourself for more information, perhaps explaining whether students are allowed to use their notes or not, or a calculator, etc. Underneath the instructions, the student can click on the quiz to start the exam. Here you see the two quizzes. The bottom one is the quiz we just created, but we will click on the top one because this is the quiz where we can show you every different question type that is possible. The student clicks Start Quiz and then the questions will appear. Now, this is just to give you an idea of the question types that are possible in Brightspace. There are true-false questions, multiple-choice questions, and each time the autosave is completed, students see a little check mark appear on the left-hand side next to the question that was saved. There are also matching questions, ordering questions, etc. And all of these, except for the written response question, are closed questions that will be graded automatically by Brightspace. The written response question needs to be graded by the teacher themselves. Then at the end, the student will click Submit Quiz to hand in their work. If the student has not answered all of the questions, they get a warning, telling them which questions are still without an answer. They can then choose to go back to the questions or to submit the quiz. The student is now brought back to the exam home screen, where they can see that they have submitted the first quiz. They have not started the second quiz yet, and we will leave this for now. Once everything is submitted or the time is up, students will log out and leave the exam hall.